Hey guys, welcome to the month of November. We've got a lot of great things coming up in the next 30 days, and I want to give you just a big flyover of what you can expect. We're going to talk about three things, and then I'm going to highlight our featured resources for this month, and then I'll leave you alone. And so I hope that this is going to be a valuable experience for you. Okay, the first thing that we need to talk about are we have some rehearsal changes actually coming up the next 8 weeks. This is for November and December. So these are going to be some important dates to remember. Now, if you remember back to history class when you were growing up, what's the big complaint that everyone has? Well, I didn't like history because it's just a bunch of dates and everything like that. And I get that. But I had an awesome history teacher growing up who would actually reenact some of the, you know, historical scenes that we were talking about. And I found it really helpful. And I know you will too. So I'm going to do this first section as the 16th president of the United States, Abraham Lincoln. Here we go. 47 years ago on Okay, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to do the accent. For November and December, we've got several weeks where we're going to be canceling the midweek rehearsal. And so you need to take note of this. And you know that I'm telling the truth because first, November 10th and 11th. This is the week that the IBSA is going to be here doing their annual meeting. And so we won't have rehearsal on Wednesday night. We've got a same band all weekend planned on Saturday and Sunday. So just come to the Saturday rehearsal. If you play in the horn section or the choir, you'll come to the Sunday morning rehearsal at 7. Everybody else who's on the schedule, you'll be there Saturday night, 4 p.m. in the chapel. Our next weekend that this will affect us is November 24th and 25th. This is the weekend after Thanksgiving. And that Wednesday night, the 21st of November, we're going to cancel rehearsal that night. Now, in the past, you might remember we've rescheduled to another night of the week. We're not doing that. We're just doing no rehearsal that week. Same band all weekend on November 24th and 25th. The next time that this is going to affect us is the end of December. This is actually the weekend of the 22nd and the 23rd. Now, this one's a little different, so take note. The weekend of December 22nd and 23rd, we're going to do a same band all weekend. We'll have our rehearsal on Saturday and then the 7 a.m. one on Sunday morning. We won't have a midweek rehearsal for that particular weekend. Same thing as before. If you're playing in the rhythm section or singing on front line, you come on Saturday night, horns and choir, you'll come on Sunday morning at the 7 o'clock rehearsal. However, there still will be a midweek rehearsal that week, but it will be for the Christmas Eve service, which is on Monday, December 24th. Okay, so just to reiterate, if you're serving the weekend of December 22nd and 23rd, we won't have a midweek rehearsal for that service, but the midweek rehearsal will still happen for the December 24th service. And finally, the weekend before New Year's, December 29th through 30th, there will be no midweek rehearsal on December 26th. So I hope that helps. Just to reiterate, the weekends that are going to be affected, November 10th and 11th, November 24th and 25th, December 22nd through 23rd, and December 29th and 30th. The band's been scheduled through the end of the year, so hop into Planning Center, see when you're on the schedule, and see if this affects you. We've also made these changes to the plans in Planning Center itself, so if you forget, just hop in, look at the plan, see when the rehearsals are scheduled. Next, it's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, and on November 30th, it's going to look a lot more like it than it already is. That's the evening that we're going to do our church-wide Christmas decoration night. If you've been around here for several years, you know what that means. We're going to meet on Friday, November 30th at 5 o'clock p.m. We'll all meet together. We'll decorate the worship center, the lobby, the cafe, several different spots around the church where we're going to put up Christmas decor, and we would love for you to be a part of it. If you like decorating, or if you just like hanging out with people and doing fun Christmassy things, and we usually put some type of Christmas movie on in the worship center. It's a fun evening, and we'll feed you. That's like the best part of it all. So come get some food, put up some Christmas decorations, and make some great memories. That's Friday, November 30th at 5 o'clock p.m. Reach out to us. Let us know if you can make it or not. Just comment below or respond to the monthly newsletter email or email Sheila or myself. Just let us know if you're going to be here because we'd love for you to be a part of this evening. And also, we need for you to be a part of this evening so we can get everything up and it just be a successful launch to the holiday season here. And the final thing that you need to know for this month is that on Sunday, December 2nd, we're going to do a worship night. This is our next worship night. And the great thing about it is we'll be using this night to sing and introduce all the music that we're going to be doing during our Christmas services in December. So you're not going to want to miss this. It'll be in the chapel at 6 o'clock p.m. on the evening of Sunday, December 2nd. Come and be a part of it. These evenings are a part of our strategy of teaching our people to sing well and inspiring our congregation to engage even deeper with their faith, and specifically through singing. You can actually check out all of the music we have planned ahead of time. Go down to the featured resources section in the email you received, and you have a link there to either Spotify, Apple Music, or YouTube. You can listen through those playlists. And we've also included a short ebook that is essentially just all the lyrics that we're going to be singing to those songs. So let me encourage you, be listening through the songs, but also be reading through the lyrics. You know, the resource that was included in last month's newsletter talked about the importance of reading through the poetry that we're singing and letting your mind, letting that just marinate over your mind so that you're thinking accurate thoughts about who God is and about your response to that. And speaking of the featured resources section, be sure to check that out. Like I mentioned, we've got the Christmas resource down there, which lets you know what's going to be happening here during Christmas. We've also got a great resource called musictheory.net. You can read more about that.